Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Eschalon Book 3. As per usual, we are just jumping on in here, and where we had last left off, I had gained a level. I think we're up to 5th now? Maybe? What are we? Level 4. We're an initiate. I don't remember what the level cap is in these. I think it was 20 in the first game, and like 25 or 30 in the second. So I would estimate it at being somewhere around there in this one. And now that I can cast some higher level divination magic, what I think I want to do here is do this. I'm going to have the second level, no, not divine heal, I want flesh boil. Level 2 on 1, and level 3 flesh boil on 2, and I'm going to throw a level 3 divine heal on 4. And guiding light, you're handy, but for the time being, I do not want to camp. For the time being, you are useless to me now. Okay, let's get on with this. Now that we got some better armor, I'm hoping that our survivability is going to be much improved. I mean, if anything, we can just sit here and grind on wolves because they're worth like 100 experience points apiece. I'm still afraid of those things. I don't even know what they are. They remind me of Netch from Morrowind, which is, I don't know, depending on how you swing, really a cool little reference or terrifying, because those Netch can be dangerous when you're a low level, especially the Bettys. Those things are mean. And they look like they can fly, I think. Well, maybe. Oh, they have range attacks. Okay, that's... And they have a 94% chance to hit me, so yeah, we're not going to be fighting those. The small cabin appears to be unused. Perhaps it's just a hunter's shelter used only during certain seasons. Well... Alas, no loot. Can I put a torch on the wall? Yes. Huh. Alright, just a little cabin, I guess. Does not appear to be anything here. I mean, I can camp in here. That could actually prove useful. Come in here, shut the door, and just rest. That I could see being, you know, pretty handy. But we do have level 3 flesh boil now. One thing I do wish is the game kind of gave you a little bit more information about the spells in the game. I don't believe it does. I think this might be a teleportation waypoint. Now, an ancient oak forest was first charted by early explorers while it was still the sacred homeland of the Akadai. As part of the greater Elder Oak Sanctuary, these trees are now protected by the Shadow Grove Rangers of West Eschalon. Oh, it is a quick travel location. Huzzah! I thought I remembered there being fast travel in these games. Well, at least we can come here now. Let me use the sign, please. Oh, wow, that's... All right, looks like Moonrise is north, unless I'm supposed to rotate this, in which case it's... That would actually be northwest. Otherwise, it's southwest. Oh, no. Well, does it change based on where I am now? That would have been clever if it did. Oh, another spell scroll. This is exciting. I know I have to identify it, but I'm trying to identify it, but you're not letting me, game. Target is obscured. What? Why does it say the target is obscured? Is it subtly whinging at me? No. Maybe I'm not casting high enough level lore. Let's try a third level lore. No. Huh. I don't know. Maybe I just can't identify it right now. Who knows? Not me. I'm just here to poke around and kill wolves. And pray I don't get attacked by any of those killer creatures. Is this a waiting point? No. No. Huh. Okay. Joke's on you, game. I don't need light to explore. I got my little glow ball. I also have a ring that is a slightly less effective glow ball. What are you gonna do about it? As I walk into an ogre or something. Oh, wolf! You're down to a 58% chance to hit me. That's better. They were in the 70s earlier. Ooh, nice crit. Come on. There we go. Oh, that one didn't drop a pell. I'm disappointed. Let's heal. Now, I know the last time I tried to do this, I was just fine. Unless I was maybe carrying the short sword. No, the game is trolling me. Last episode, I was fine casting spells with all of this stuff on. I even healed myself. Okay, can I do this with a short sword? Yes, okay. Then I will just fight with a short sword. Let's flesh boil this sucker. 9 damage, that is much better. I freaking accidentally moved. Want to buy movement confirmation toggle. Maybe at least in combat. Who knows? Kill it. There we go. Hey, we got a pelt off of this one. 12 gold pieces. That's 3 food. I want to heal myself. Dang it. Higher level one. Oh, yeah. That's 6 mana for... Actually, not that much more hit points. 10 or 11. I don't know if that's necessarily worth it. All right, what do we have here? Locked. Another wolf. Flesh boil? No, don't have enough mana. Okay, that's okay. We have melee combat. Smote, and another pelt. This is acceptable. Go ahead and, heal myself. 6, I don't know. I'm sure I could math out whether or not it's better to cast lower level or higher level healing magic. Is this a pass? Can't tell, no. I was hopeful. Taking it kind of slow, just in case there's more wolves floating around out here. I don't want to accidentally... Oh, this is the end of the map. All right. What's on the other side? Moonrise. All right, is this a town? That's kind of what I want to know. I'm going to actually camp. Let the light come. I'll pay the food tax to be able to perhaps see here. All right. That's really all I wanted. Ah, this does look like it. Oh, the blood worries me. I'm gonna save because we haven't saved yet. Already 5 episodes in. Oh, this is tempting though. Yeah, this is a town. Sweet. Moonrise is the premier port city of Wilderen and the largest established city in all of the Western continent. With its dark history long behind, this beautiful port was once again become a shining bastion of civilization and culture in the wilds of Wilderen. We welcome your visit and encourage you to stop by our fine merchants while you stay in our gem of the sea. Sweet. I'm gonna have to find the town portal thing in the first town just to save myself having to haul my happy ass all the way back there every so often. Okay, what do we have here? Some gold! Who leaves gold in a barrel? What is up with that? Video games, explain. Okay, so this looks like a tavern, and taverns mean food, and we need food. You see a cheerful woman wearing an apron. She waves happily as you enter. Welcome, welcome. Come, have a seat. You look weary from your travels, as so you should be. Moonrise is quite a journey from wherever it is you came from. I could use some new supplies. What do you have? You buy pelts? No. Oh, actually, yes, you do. No, I'm not gonna pay you 90 gold to figure out what it is. Ouch. I will buy the fish. That is worth 4. I can afford 4 for food. I will also buy the biscuit rations. Yes, and an extra potato. And the plump pot. Let's see here. Don't really have anything else. Map of Mistfell. Gems. I'm gonna hold on to this map. This might be useful long term. I don't know. Okay. So now that we have thrown all of our money away on food, throw that there. Some biscuits. Throw my map down here. And the plump gods. There. How much is a knight? 30 gold. No thanks. Not that interested. That is not worth it for filling up my food and drink. Up here, magical place, huh? See a woman with long, wild hair walking around the magic shop. A small ferret runs back and forth across her shoulders, shyly hiding in her locks. Magic greetings, she proclaims as you enter. I am Mitza, owner of the Fairy Dust and Moonbeams Magic Shop. Look around, and please let me know if there's anything I can get you. Have any odd jobs that you need done? I could use some gold in my pocket. Well, I do need something, but I doubt you'll be able to help me. There's a very rare blooming tree up on the slopes of the Astral Mountains I'm interested in. The tree produces a sap that can make the most fantastic healing potions. So you'd like me to fetch some? No. If you can only retrieve a bit of sap of me, I would just use it up in a few months and be without again. What I really need is a more dependable supply. I would like you to retrieve a nut from the tree so I can attempt to grow my own here in Moonrise. If I had my own tree, I'd have an endless supply of sap. I'll pay you very, very well if you bring me a nut from the flowering tree in the Astral Range. Sure. Thank you. Now, in case you haven't noticed, all the northern routes to the Astral Range are closed off. You'll need to find a proper route to reach the Highlands. Okay. I would like to see what you have for sale. All of the things that I can't afford, essentially. Looks like, haste. Malachi's Gruel. That's another one that I would like to have, be able to create my own food. I remember Trap Kill being pretty useful in the first one, but again, Sunder Flesh. Again, though, it's a case of not wanting to spread myself too thin. Alright. Let's see if we can identify this scroll now. Yeah, okay. Scroll of Leatherskin, so that is what it was. It was just that, our armor was keeping us from using the spell, and the game wasn't telling me that. Alright, so we have a buff now. Let's go ahead and... 16. That's what they're doing. 11? Wow. Can I do 2? No, 8. Alright, so we can do first level leather skin. I want to just see how long this lasts. So give me a duration by any chance. 20 turns! But it gives me 5 armor and 5 damage reduction. The damage reduction is more exciting to me than anything. So that's actually, I would say, adequate. I generally speaking don't want to have a lot of buffs and stuff that I have to worry about. But I will, you know, deal with a couple here and there. Alright, so we've got the temple. Any places that I can apply the adventurer attacks to? I wonder if that's gonna count as stealing if we take the money from the well. Nope. Wait. Hey, guard. Guard, what's freaking? I'm watching you. Okay. You do that. I don't remember how the thieving worked in these games. I don't remember if it was like you could gank things so long as nobody saw you, apparently. I think that this might actually just be some leather jerky, or like some beef jerky, I should say. I don't know. Yeah, dried meat. I love how we don't know what dried meat is. And a potion of nimbleness, vendor trash. Like I said, I don't want to be having to babysit a bunch of random items. Bottle of wine, another guide to leather armor materials, which is just going to stay there because I have no desire to take it. Some more rooms and a barrel. It's going to, it's not going to block my way. I'm actually really happy with that gold we found. All right, that one's locked. That one's locked. Accursed doors! Now I could try picking those, but from what I recall, trying to pick a lock in the Vision of Guards will get you in trouble. Wine, which I'm actually probably just going to vendor. And come on now. And some gold. Right, so we're sitting at 110 gold now. That's not bad. We're certainly on the way. Is that another dried well? Nope. That's what I wanted. We are certainly on the way of being able to afford that gruel spell, which I would love to be able to buy. Hey there. What do you got? Buy my wine. Gold, will you buy a potion? No, that doesn't surprise me. Alright, back. I will be on my way. Let's see, I don't think that we really have anything to do here specifically. No. I really want to meet that woman in the Basilt Dunes. Basilt Dunes, yeah, I think. Can I just quick travel from anywhere? Because if that's the case, just use food. Yes, okay. So it uses food and water. But it gets me there. That's handy, and I can apparently do it from anywhere. All right, good to know. Good to know. We are running slightly low on food, so I do kind of want to meander my way back towards the first town yet again, both to hit the tavern for cheap sleep, as well as hitting the little waypoint there so that we can fast travel back. Because now that I have two towns to bop between back and forth, that'll make keeping stocked up on food and stuff a little bit easier. Because if I recall correctly, the shop turnaround is fairly long. I think it's like a couple weeks. It might be like maybe 14 or 21 in-game days. So you've got to be careful of starvation and stuff. It'll be less of a problem when I can cast that food spell, I'm hoping. I am hoping. So let's see. Oh, I almost walked right past this one. Founded in 657 in the heart of the Wildern Boglands, the purpose of the Sea Warden's Guild is to maintain a light to guide ships through the Strait of Gales, to offer a place of rest to weary sea travels far from home, and to maintain memorial sites in honor of lost sailors. Alright. Well, that's handy. That means that I can go straight from town to harassing these bandits with little issue, which is probably what we're going to do after I hit the waypoint there. Okay, we'll just cross over here. I could go for the other one that's a little further down. Like that one right there, but no need to, especially considering the one that I just took keeps me from having to wade through any of the bogs. And truth be told, I don't want to risk getting poisoned or diseased or whatever it was that got me the last time and was halving my stats, because that's horrible, man. That is just horrible. So I want to check. Alright, yeah, we're still missing our gloves. That's... sucks a little bit. Like I said, I totally forgot about it, but mechanically I'm fine with it. It's just something that I did not take into account when I was buying things. It's okay. I suppose realistically I could equip the stuff, and I probably will when, you know, need be. But yeah, look at this. It's just sitting in the center of town. I'm a freaking idiot. Spot marks the claim of Lord Haggis Dragon Boom for the exclusive mineral rights to Weeping Mountain and all surrounding peaks and hills. Please see General Manager Morwin Dragonboom, or Dagonboom. You're inquiring about work. We are not. However, we now have the town thing. Hey there! Do you have anything back? Yes, you do. So her stuff has restocked, which pleases me. I'm tempted to buy yet more food. I'm gonna buy more biscuit rations, I think. And I'm gonna say that's it. Okay, I'm gonna keep going. Actually, knowing that, well, here, let's get our room. Take the room, get out of here. And you'll know that it used less food and water because we slept during the night. It sleeps you until the next day. It sleeps you, I love that. You sleep until the next day. So, since we went to bed later in the evening, we used less food and water. So if she is restocked, have you? Hold still. I think he might have already. Yeah, I think the last time we were here when we looked at his stuff, that was his restock stuff. Because I seem to recall him having some pants last time, some chain leggings. Okay, so back to the guild. We'll hike over here. I'm gonna save because I fear everything. And we've got 12 minutes to throw myself at these guys and die horribly. How did I miss that? Okay, so we have archers. That worries me. Hey there, buddy. Come get me. I have armor and stuff now. 82% chance to hit. And then he hits like a friggin' truck. Actually, to be fair, so do I. Run away. Oh, he got me on the fleeing! You cheap sucker! You have died! As you fall to the ground, you feel a rustling sensation as your essence is pulled from your body to join the force of the cosmos. Suddenly, as if you're seeing stars for the first time, you're in awe as you gaze at the breadth of eternity stretching before you. Okay, so we can probably fight one of these guys one-on-one, but past that, I have a feeling we are slightly outmatched. So knowing that, we're actually going to head towards the Bog Silt Dunes, or whatever their area is called. Because, dang it, plot. we are slowly progressing towards our next level. I could sit in the other area and just grind on wolves, and the temptation is certainly there to do so because they are worth a lot of experience considering they're not particularly dangerous. Is there a path going up here? And the temptation is certainly there to just kind of, no, just camp there and, you know, just keep grinding out XP. But that is something that if I were to do it, I would do it off screen. And I'm not even sure that I want to do it necessarily. I see you over there, slime. Don't think I don't. See, what I should have done is buffed myself with leather skin before I fought that guy, but I totally forgot about it. The secondary reason that I don't like having to manage a bunch of buffs. Before you extends a vast beach of sand marked with jagged volcanic rocks and small rises of dunes. To the west is an immense ocean. There are no ships on it that you can see. Okay. This reminds me of the area with all of the Torax in the end of the second game. It was just kind of a giant wasteland with this huge fortress in the center of it. Oh no, it's an- I'm not gonna waste mana on a flesh boil. You little shit, come here. If it flees, I'll flesh boil it, but it's not going to because it's dead. Top our hit points off. Okay, so yeah, it's looking like the better heal is definitely worth it mana-wise, so 15 points is acceptable. Unknown, it looks like a freaking pen and quill, a quill and ink. Quill and inkwell! Bronze throwing knives, I'm actually gonna hold on to these because I might be able to use them to set off powder kegs. And if I can, oh yes. Oh yes, okay, so we've got some of the, oh, is this who we're looking for? Is it? Yes! You see a woman tending to her campsite. She appears to be gathering her belongings as if to be leaving soon, and although she is occupied with the task, she doesn't seem surprised by your sudden arrival. You then realize that she has obviously been expecting you. You've made it! I knew you would eventually locate me if I threw some lures into the water, and not a moment too soon, I should say. She pauses, then smiles as she sees a confused look upon your face. Do you not remember me? We'll go with no, because I honestly don't. I do not remember you, we've met before. I once lived in Tangled Tree Forest in Theramore. We met a few years ago before the province fell. You came to me asking about a pendant that you had in your possession, and due to the circumstance of that meeting, I was unable to tell you the entire truth about myself. For the purposes of keeping your mind clear of any past memories, I acted as though we were complete strangers. In actuality, we had previously met. You yourself had set up our first meeting, and I was awaiting you to bring me the pendant to my home so that I could guide you to the next part of your journey. This was a plan set forth between you and our common friend Erebor before you erased your own memory. Okay, there seems to be so much of my past I don't remember. That would be a lasting effect of the serum you drank, which destroyed your memories. The enemy has the ability to look into our minds, and therefore memories can be dangerous to possess. He uses your memories to track you, to anticipate where you're going, and what you are doing. By erasing your memories, you have evaded the One for several years now. But now you're here in Wilderan, and in order for us to move forward, you need to understand how you got here. So how did I get here? A man named Corin, a man you trusted, sent you to Talishorn on a mission to destroy two of the Crux Stones. It was a quest that was meant to stop the One from gaining all four Crux, and while Corin's intentions were initially pure, his plan was misguided. Erebor believes Corin was under the influence of the One, for why would he send you into the house of the enemy with the very object they sought? The Torax army is 10,000 strong. Did you not think it was odd that you walked into the Tower of Talishorn with such little resistance? It was exactly what the enemy had wanted. However, the One did not expect that in his attempt to destroy you, that you would be teleported so far away with the Crux he so desperately seeks. I don't remember that. When you were teleported from Talishorn, it was not just distance that you traveled, but time as well. Lilith notices the puzzled look on your face. You heard me correctly, Devon. Although you may feel as though you were just standing in Talishorn a few days past, the event actually happened over 6 months ago. The blast from the Crux was so violent it cast you forward in time. Our good friend Erebor estimates the time and place you would likely emerge, and I was sent out ahead of your arrival to locate you. So here I am. Alright, tell me what you know of Erebor. How do you know him? He's leading the war against the One. Now that Corin is gone. He's head of the guild Creus Vindica, whose sole purpose is to prevent the four Crux Stones from uniting, and he's a good friend to both of us. You might assume that I am a member of the Creus Vindica as well, but I am not. My past is of a less honorable notoriety. I was a shadow tracker, and I was one of the best. You see, if someone wanted an item recovered or a person found, they came to me. My methods of tracking and recovery were not always ethical and rarely legal, but I got the job done. And that's how I came to know Erebor. Many years ago, he hired me to recover several antiquities that were stolen from Shadowmerc, and ever since, we have been good friends. He's like a grandfather to me, and I trust few others as much as I trust him. When he asked for my help in locating you, I did not hesitate. I will do everything I can to support his efforts. So what now? That is between Erebor and you. His only quest for me was to give you this letter once I located you. It contains information that you will need in order to continue from here. He demanded that I not read the letter, as the information may hasten the enemy's search for you and the crux you now hold. That is all I know. I have no further instructions for you. I'm heading back to the east to investigate the reports of goblins seen in Wilderan, after which I report to Erebor. Lilith hands you a letter with a secured wax seal, then turns away and continues gathering her supplies together. Hurry now, it's time we part ways. Perhaps our paths will cross again soon. Alright. And did that... Seriously, that just, I think, gained us a level? Holy crap! Alright, I'll take it. For my skill points, I'm going to throw them all into swords, because I want to get the 10th level ability for it here. Chance of performing masterful riposte. And then all of my stat points are going into strength. Yes. Nice. Did our XP requirements go up? I don't know. I think they did. Regardless, I'm pleased with that. Erebor's letter. Devon, I hope this letter finds you well. Let me quickly fill you in on the details of what I know now. 6 months ago, you were sent to Talishorn with the Crux of Fire in order to destroy it by uniting it with the Crux of Ages. The creature we've called the One appeared unexpectedly with the intention of killing you and taking the Crux of Fire. However, upon being struck by a beam of energy, you were inadvertently teleported to Wilderan. I saw this event happen. I was able to witness the encounter through the scrying glasses both you and Korn possessed. After much research, I was able to conclude with relative certainty where you would arrive. Much more information has come to light in these past 6 months. I believe that the creature we've called the Orakur are not from this world. What I mean is they're not part of our normal world as we know it now, in this present day. Whether they have come as from Eschalon's past or its future, I cannot be sure of. They seem to have knowledge of an exceptional form of magic, and with it, they have been able to bend time. They can see into the minds of others and influence them. I have learned that the Orakur we've called the One has a name that the other Orakur refer to him by, Malkur. Malkur desires to bring the four Crux Stones together, to use them for some purpose that is against the will of the other Orakur. To add to this, I believe the dwarves are involved in some way. Really? But I have not yet figured out what role they play in this matter. We need more information before we can advance, and it is imperative that we locate the other Crux Stones. You have the Crux of Fire, Malkur has the Crux of Ages. The other two gemstones are still undiscovered, and I believe they were drawn, or you were drawn to that reason because one or both are near. Securing these other two stones is our only chance for preventing misuse. We must apply wisdom in this matter. There exists a very old friend of mine named Kara Miklan Silver, whom I have not talked to in many, many years. If he still lives, he would be the oldest living being in all of Eschalon, and his wisdom far exceeds that of anyone I have ever known. I need you to make contact with him and ask for guidance. Herein lies the problem. Kara Miklan is imprisoned by a Barian warlord named Elundar, who keeps him locked away in a dungeon deep in the Astral Range. There's no way Elundar will allow you to speak with Kara Miklan, and it would take an army to free him, an army which we do not have. In contemplating this situation, I have crafted an idea. You may be able to buy the warlord's grace by bringing him a gift, something he truly desires, and with that, he may grant you a short visit with Kara Miklan. I do not know what this gift would be, but it would have to be magnificent. Go to Moonrise and speak with the owner of the Black and Bone Tavern. She has ties to the warlord of Lundar and might be able to suggest an appropriate gift. Although you may think you are fierce or elusive enough to make your way into Kara Miklan without help, I strongly advise against such attempts. You are too valuable to lose to a foolish act of bravery or heroism. I will make an attempt to contact you soon. Until we meet, press on with courage and wisdom. Your good friend, Erebu Stonebeard. Alright. Well, now we know what we have to do. We have to go back to Moonrise, which is actually just a quick fast travel away. I kind of actually want to explore this area a little bit, though. And we are actually almost at a half an hour. So I'm going to save and call it here. As per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. And I will catch you all next time, wherein more plotline. Until then.